She always taking pictures when she do people hair. But when I'm done, she didn't take my picture. And you know why? Because she know that it looked a mess. Like, she know that it looked a mess. Like, because why would you not take pictures of your work?
Tennessee, met you downtown, I can feel the chemistry. Time of the sink, girl, I got the energy. Light skin, brown eyes, little ebony.
All right, hey guys, my name is Jada and welcome to my channel and welcome back to my channel. So, before we even get into this video, I'm gonna need y'all to, like, subscribe, like, right now. I'm gonna give y'all 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, so now that you subscribed, we can get into the video. So, this is gonna be a story time. It seemed like you guys like my last story time, so I'm gonna give you another one. This is a story time on why I don't trust internet hairstylists, okay? Because they will finesse you. They will really finesse you. Like, they will get your money and finesse you, okay? So let me tell you how the story all started. So this is back when, like, Facebook was, like, what year was this? 2014 summer. So Facebook is lit. Facebook is popping. Like, yeah. So this girl on Facebook, she's, like, Facebook famous. She does hair. So she was posting, like, all summer, like, her doing people hair. And she was, like, body bagging this hair. Like, I was like, bro, I want her to do my hair. Like, she was finessing. Like, it looked really good. Like, and at the time, keep in mind, nobody was wearing closures, or, well, some people were wearing closures, but not really. Like, the frontals and all of that was not, like, really big yet. So it was mostly, like, leave outs. Yeah. So she used to do this thing, like, she called it it's called a vixen sewing. So that's, like, a real versatile sewing. The middle, back, front, you leave all of that out. So basically, like, you put weave in those other four areas so that it looks like yours, and that you could wear, like, half up, half down, and two ponytails, wear it in a ponytail. Like, you could literally do everything with it because it's so versatile, because most of your hair is out. So she was, like real famous with those. Like, she did those, like, really good. So I'm looking at it all summer, and I'm like, yo, I want her to do my hair. Like, I really want her to do my hair for back to school. So usually I go to the hair salon, and I was like, nah, I gotta let her do my hair because she's gonna finesse. So my mom was like, no, just go to the hair salon, blah blah blah. And I'm like, no, I want her to do my hair, nah. So mom was like, whatever, that's on you, whatever. Mom was like, you don't know her, do you know anybody that wants her? And I'm like, no, but I really want her to do my hair because, yo, she really seemed like she knew what she was doing. So long story short, I hit her up, like, oh, I'm interested in this vixen sewing. She said the price, we set an appointment, and that was that. So the day of the appointment, my dad drove me to her neighborhood. She lives in the same, like, city as me, but she lived kind of far, like 30 minutes away. So my dad drove me there to her apartment, and he waited outside for me. So the first thing I did when I got to her, like, apartment, I knocked on her door. She answered the door. She's really nice. Keep in mind, she is really nice, honestly. Like, she was real nice the whole time. So she's like, oh, you're here on time, I need to go to the beauty supply. So that was strike number one, because if you know that my appointment was at 2:30, what do you mean I'm here on time? Like, am I not supposed to be here on time? Like, why, if my appointment is at 2:30, you're telling me you need to go to the beauty supply? And then at that, you're literally just doing a vixen sewing. Like, literally all you need is needle and thread and a flat iron. So what do you need at the beauty supply that you don't got? And a comb. I'm sure you have a comb and grease and stuff like that in your house. So that was strike number one. So I was like, oh, okay. So I'm going to just go wait in a car with my dad until you come back. Because, like, I was not about to just sit in her house. But that's exactly what I did. I ended up sitting in her house. Strike number two. She was like, no, it's fine. My aunt can start braiding your hair. Bro, am I paying your aunt to do my hair, or am I paying you to do my hair? So her aunt braids my hair. Keep in mind, her aunt is mad big. Like, we all got big aunts, so it's not like I'm not trying to, like, be funny, but her aunt is mad big. And I'm literally sitting in between this lady's lap. You know when you're a kid and you sit in between somebody's lap and your mom does your hair, and you sit between her lap and you mad tired and you just, like, be laying on the side like this? that's literally how I was laying in this lady's lap, and I did not even know her. Like, I don't understand, I don't know what was wrong with me that I even, like, allowed that to even happen, because me today, I would never. So I'm literally, like, sitting in her lap while she braids my hair. Her aunt, grandmother, whoever it was, she was not nice, though. Like, she was cool, so it wasn't, like, she was nasty, or she didn't stink. Like, it was fine, but it was just, like, I'm paying you to do a service. I'm a person that you don't know, and you got me sitting in between this lady's legs, like, what? So she comes back from the beauty supply like a whole like hour or two later, like mad long, and then she like she does my hair. Keep in mind, my dad is outside the whole time, like he's outside the whole time just waiting. So she starts doing my hair. Keep in mind, her aunt already braided it, so literally all she had to do was sew the hair into the four sections. So she's just taking mad long. I'm just relaxing. Like, she don't have no mirrors, so I don't know how my hair is looking. I'm just hoping for the best. But you know that feeling you get when somebody's doing your hair wrong? Y'all know, everybody knows that feeling. That's the feeling I got. Like, I just got the feeling that she was doing my hair wrong, and she was. When my hair was done, I was literally like, I was in shock. Like, this is not the Facebook work that I was seeing. Like, this is not what I was seeing on Facebook. Because, bro, my hair looked like a hot mess. Like, to the point where I was about to cry. Like, I was about to cry in here. Like, she showed me my hair. First of all, I gave her 3 bundles of hair. Guess how much bundles she used in my hair? 1. If I give you 3 bundles, why would you only use 1? So I said to her, I gave you 3 bundles, like, why would you only use 1? She was like, oh, because it's a mix and so on. You see how thick my natural hair is. Why would you only use one? Like, that makes literally no sense. And keep in mind, I was natural at the time. And she says she know how to do natural hair. She was posting pictures on Facebook like, oh, she's 100% natural. She has very thick hair and I was able to do it. Like, so I'm thinking that she could blend it and do all of that. Like, she saw my hair before she left. If that was the case, she should have been like, oh no, I don't think you should get that hairstyle. I don't think I could work with that. Like, bro, my hair was mad puffy. I only had 1 bundle in. So y'all can only imagine how it looked. It looked bad. So I'm sitting there, I'm like, I don't like it. Like, I'm like, I don't like it. She was like, do you want to try to put some curls in it? Bro, what is curls gonna do? I'm thinking in my head like, yo, what is curls gonna do? I was like, curls is probably not gonna do nothing, but you could try it. She was like, oh, that's $10 extra. At this point, I was just like, okay, well, that's our only hope, even though I know it's not gonna do nothing. She put the curls in, still looked a mess. It looked even worse than before. So it was just a lose-lose situation. The hair just wasn't done right. So when she was done, I'm like, I don't like this. Like, I don't like it. She's like, oh, she was so nice though. Like, that's one thing I can say, that she was real nice. Like, she was nice, but she didn't know what she was doing. So she was like, oh, if you want, you could come back. At this time it's like 12 o'clock at night. I was there since 2:30. My dad's waiting in the car and it's 12 o'clock. So I don't know how that even adds up, because it doesn't to me. But she's like, oh, if you want, you could come back another day and I'll just do you like a whole hairstyle for $50. Excuse me? It's upsetting me and my homegirls, because why do you think that I would even come back? Like, why would I come back here? Like, what made you think that I would even come back? At the time though, she was Facebook famous and she was like always fighting and always getting, she was so nice, but she was always fighting and always like arguing with people on Facebook. So I was like, I don't even want to try to violate me on Facebook. So I was like, you know what? It's whatever. I'm going to take my L. And I'm the type of person, like, if I know I'm about to take an L, I'm going to just take that L, especially when I knew the risk getting involved. Everybody was telling me don't go to her and I still went to her. I still didn't listen, and I knew what it was, so I was just like, you know what, I'm just take that out. So I was like, no, it's okay, I won't be coming back, and whatever. And then when I was leaving, her aunt was in the living room, and I was like, oh girl, your hair looks popping. And I was like, no, it don't. I was like, no, it don't. She was like, what are you talking about? It looks mad good. I'm like, no, it don't. I was like, good night, good night, good night. And I walked to the car with that little, you know, where you walk out your hairstylist, hot apartment, whatever, salon chair, and you say you like your hair, you don't like it. I walked in the car with the, like, the stupid face. Like, my dad, as soon as I got in the car, it was dark. So he said, because he could just tell by, like, my attitude, like, when your hair looks bad, your whole vibe is off. So he said, turn on the light so he could see. He was like, of course dads don't know. He's like, what's wrong with it? I'm like, what's right with it? Like, what's right with it? He's like, if you didn't like it, why you didn't tell her? And I was like, I did tell her, but it was like, he was like, do you want to go get your money back? Because mind you, it was really his money. He was like, you want to go there and let her redo it? You want to get your money back? And I'm like, it's whatever. I don't even care. I'm going to get it redone. But he made me pay to get it redone, which is understandable because he paid for it to get done. And I'm just let somebody finesse me. So he was like, if you want to take it out, that's on you, but you pay for it. And I was like, okay. And I got home. My mom was like, I told you. And I can't even argue because she did tell me and I didn't want to listen. My mom was mad. My mom was like, for 3 days straight, like every day, let's go over there and get that money. Nah, nah, nah. She know this on the ground. Nah, 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 nah. I'm like, no. But if it was me today, I wouldn't even have walked out with even paying her. Oh yeah, she didn't even charge me for the curls. She was like, I'm not even gonna charge you for the curls. Okay. Well, I don't know if she thought that was like a little discount or something, but it was still an L regardless, and you know. That's basically the end of the story. That's why I don't trust. And you know another thing too? She always taking pictures when she do people hair. But when I'm done, she didn't take my picture. And you know why? Because she know that it looked a mess. Like, she knows that it looked a mess. Like, because why would you not take pictures of your work? That's not, I know. She knows she was dead wrong, bro. She knew she was dead wrong. But yeah, that's pretty much the end of this video. That's the reason why I don't trust no hairstylist that I see on the internet. Like, I'm sorry, but I can't trust it. Even Arrogant Tay, I need to see in person because I don't trust it. Nah, let me stop. His work is too good. He's the only person that I do trust on the internet. Everybody else, I don't trust it. I'm sorry, because people be editing pictures, acting like you talking about where's the lace, knowing they edited the whole lace, the whole thing is blurry. Like, y'all be acting like y'all could do hair and y'all can't. Now, I just do my own hair. If my hair looks bad, guess what? That's on me, and I got it done for free. So if I want to fix it, I can fix it. If it looks bad, that's my fault. I can't put the blame on nobody else. But yeah, like I said, end of the video. Make sure you like, comment, share, and subscribe. And I'll see y'all guys in my next one.
Tennessee, met you downtown, I can feel the chemistry. Time of the sink, girl, I got the energy. Light skin, brown eyes, little ebony.